Hello everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel, that is Biochemistry Basics by Dr. Amit, and today's topic for Biochemistry Rapid Revision series is fat soluble vitamin. As we all are aware, there are four important fat soluble vitamins. First one is vitamin A, second one is vitamin D, third one is vitamin E, and the fourth one is vitamin K. We will discuss and rapidly revise all these four important vitamins. So first we will see vitamin A. So there are three active forms of vitamin A. First one is retinol, which is an alcohol form. Second one is the retinal, which is an aldehyde form. And the third one is retinoic acid, which is an acid form. And among these three forms, retinol is important for the reproduction function, while retinol and retinal are important for the normal vision. Retinoic acid is important. It plays an important role in the regulation of expression of gene during growth and development. And apart from all this, vitamin A also plays an important role as an antioxidant, that is beta-carotene. Beta-carotene plays an important role as an antioxidant. Now, what are the sources of vitamin A? So, vitamin A sources are fish liver oil, then milk and milk-derived products, green leafy vegetables, yellow and red fruits like mangoes, papayas and carrots. Now what happens if there is a deficiency of vitamin A? So deficiency manifestation of vitamin A, first one is the night blindness, that is impaired vision during dim light. There will be the increase in the dark adaptation time. And if this night blindness is not treated, then it will be converted to the xerophthalmia. In the xerophthalmia, conjunctiva and cornea becomes dry, thick and wrinkled. Then conjunctiva becomes dry, thick and wrinkled, and cornea becomes very dull and hazy, and it loses transparency due to the keratinization. Another important deficiency manifestation is Betot spot. Betot spot is the triangular white patch on the conjunctiva on the either side of the cornea. Fine. Another important deficiency manifestation is keratomalacia. Keratomalacia is the softening of cornea because of necrosis and ulceration. Fine. Another important deficiency manifestation of vitamin A is the skin becomes dry, rough and scaly, and there will be the retardation of growth in the children. So these are the deficiency manifestation of vitamin A. Now what is the daily requirement of vitamin A? So that is the 800 to 1000 retinol equivalent. So that is all about vitamin A. Now second important vitamin is vitamin D, which is known as the sunshine vitamin, because it is synthesized with the help of sunlight in the skin from 7D hydrocholesterol. And the active form of vitamin D is the 125-dihydrocholecalciferol, which is also known as the calcitriol. And this activation of vitamin D occurs in the two organs. First one is the liver and second one is the kidney. Now, what are the important sources of vitamin D? So first one is the sunlight, second one is the cod liver oil, and the third one is the egg yolk. Now, what are the functions of vitamin D? So vitamin D is important for the regulation of calcium homeostasis, that is maintenance of the calcium level. And the second important function of vitamin D is the bone mineralization. Fine. And the regulation of calcium level occur at three levels. First one is in the intestine, second one is in the bone, and the third one is in the kidney. Now what happens if there is a deficiency of vitamin D? So deficiency of vitamin D leads to rickets in the children and osteomalacia in the adults. What are the characteristic features of rickets? There are various characteristic features of rickets. First one is the weight-bearing bones are affected. So there will be the bow leg and knock knee, then pigeon-like chest. Then there will be the swelling of costochondral junction, which will lead to the rachitic rosacea. Then there will be the Harrison sulcus, that is transverse depression extending outward from costal cartilage to the axilla. Fine, so these are the various features of rickets. Now, what are the daily requirement of vitamin D? So daily requirement of vitamin D is 200 to 400 international unit. So that is all about vitamin D. Now third important fat soluble vitamin, that is vitamin E, and the active form of vitamin E is the alpha tocopherol. The sources of vitamin E is the germ oil, fish liver oil, then soya and corn oils. What are the function of vitamin E? So vitamin E is the very potent natural antioxidant, and it will act as a quencher of free radicals. Fine. It will help in the, it will prevent the lipid peroxidation, and it will protect the RBC from the hemolysis. Fine. So these are the important functions of vitamin E. Now what happens if there is a deficiency of vitamin E? So it will lead to the hemolytic anemia and retrolental fibroplasia in premature infants. what is the daily requirement of vitamin E? So that is 8 to 10 milligram. So that is all about vitamin E, which is also known as the alpha tocopherol. Now, last fat soluble vitamin is the vitamin K, and there are various active forms of vitamin K. First one is the phylloquinone, which is the plant derived one, which is also known as the vitamin K1. Then second one is the menaquinone, which is the animal which is synthesized in the intestinal gut flora, and the third synthetic one is the menadione, fine, which is a vitamin K3. What are the sources of vitamin K? So vitamin K is present in green leafy vegetables, then cheese, meat and egg yolk. Fine, what is the function of vitamin K? So vitamin K play important role in the blood coagulation. Fine, it is required for the activation of clotting factors. There are four important vitamin K dependent clotting factors. First one is clotting factor 2, then 7, 9 and 10. So this vitamin K play important role in the gamma carboxylation of glutamic acid residue of this clotting factors. So that is the function of vitamin K. In the deficiency of vitamin K, it will lead to the increased bleeding and clotting time, and there will be the various hemorrhagic disorder happens in the newborn infants, because newborn infants has a very low reserve of vitamin K, because the liver is immature, gut is sterile, and the breast milk also contain very low amount of vitamin K. What is the daily requirement of vitamin K? So that is 70 to 140 microgram. That is all about four important fat soluble vitamins. Thank you for watching. Please like, share and subscribe Biochemistry Basics by Dr. Amit, and don't forget to press the bell icon so you can get all the notifications from it. Thank you.